my son Austin Cook. This is our dancer and my mentor, Lindetta Alsberry, and her husband here. We will be, we're presenting the program African American History through storytelling. And it will involve drumming and dancing, a lot of engagement. And I'm gonna start off with Watuazuri. Do you know what that means? It means hello, beautiful people, because you are beautiful. Okay, can you say Watu?
Watu.
Okay, Watu. Wait, wait. I'm gonna start with Jumbo. Jumbo.
Jumbo.
Jumbo.
Jumbo.
Jumbo. Jumbo.
Jumbo. Jumbo.
Jumbo.
Jumbo.
Watu. I could say hello in. Yes.
Spanish.
Oh, is that?
Hola.
What is it?
Hola.
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 Hola. Hola.
Hola.
Hola.
Hola.
Hola. Hola. What's another language I can say hello or greeting in? Yes.
French.
French. What is that?
Bonjour.
Okay. Bonjour.
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 Bonjour. Bonjour.
Bonjour.
What's another language I can say hello in? Ni ao. My son used to live in China. China. He lives in Egypt now. What did she say?
She said something.
What was
she
it?
She said her name.
Okay. Okay. That's good. Ni ao.
Meow.
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 Meow. I hope I said that right, son. Okay, another way we can say shalom or salom. Let's do it salom this way. It means peace. Salom.
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 Salom. What about what's up? Hello, everybody. Come on in if you're just coming in. We're just starting the program. I'm Pamela Purnell, and we're doing African American history through storytelling. Do you know, is Africa a continent or a country? Very good. Come here, I wonder how many countries are in this continent. Is it 20, 30, 40, over 50? What do you think? Over 50 countries in this continent of Africa. Has anybody ever went to Florida? Have you gone to Florida? Raise your hand. You have? So you know, we're up here in Pennsylvania, central Illinois, and also in Center. We had to drive all the way down to Florida to go to Florida, which is where his father's from. And Florida sits parallel, almost parallel to Africa. 90% of Africa is under Florida. So it's just, you gotta go to Florida to throw your ball all the way over to Africa.
Yeah.
That's far away. Far away. Well, let's start with stories from Africa. So I'm gonna tell you stories from Africa, and then we're gonna go to the States and do some stories that may have wound up in the islands. The first story I'm gonna tell you is about Anansi. Every country, as we did those languages, they have folk tales and they have songs and they have dancing. And there's always a trickster. Well, this trickster was Anansi the spider. And the sky god had given Anansi all of this wisdom. And it was in a basket. He had given him all of this wisdom in the basket. And he said, you must share that with everyone. And he started thinking, would invent things, and he would build huts, and he would build ships. He said, oh, what else can I do? And he would find ways to make money, and he would always have something he could come up with because he had all the knowledge and all the wisdom, and he didn't listen to the sky god to share it with anyone. He started thinking, what if somebody comes to take it from me? You know what I have to do? I'm going to have to take all of this and put it, take it to the highest tree. And so he started trying to take it to the highest tree. I'm going to go to the big heaven in the sky. Bring it down a little bit. I'm going to go to the... Look at the floor. Okay. I'm going to go to the big heaven in the sky. And I know what I did. I didn't turn this on. I need my technician. I didn't turn this on. Can you guys hear me now? One day I'm going to go to the big heaven in the sky to be with the God of the universe and my wife. And daughter, someone must marry you.
And he will be someone on the land. He must be strong, he must be clever, and he must be good. And I will choose a peace for the land.
And the first one to try was the elephant.
An elephant.
And all you have to do is say, I can be king. I can do this thing.
I can be king. I can do this thing.
Say it really loud.
I can be king. I can do this thing.
But the first thing you do, you must throw the spear in the air and count to 10. Before it hits the ground.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
He didn't make it. Show me your angry face. Be angry or sad face. Okay, then you go back till you sleep. Well, the elephant didn't do it. So the next animal to try was the bush ox. Who wants to be the bush ox? Come on. And I forgot to tell them. In Africa, there's always dancing, so the bush ox had to dance first. Come on, come on. You want to show her the dance? So the first thing, they have to dance first. She's going to show her dance, and then she's going to throw the spear in the air. Okay, go ahead. Count. didn't make it.
Oh, oh, but she's not mad about it. She's just laughing. Oh, I didn't make it. Okay. Thank you. Show her some hand. Give her some love. And the next animal will cry. Let me see. Who walks like this?
Monkey.
Who? And the monkey can talk really fast, so I know he can do it. Who's going to try to throw the stick in the air? Come on in. Okay. And the monkey tried to do it. Let's try again. But first, she had to dance. He had to dance. Okay, come closer. Everybody clap. Trying to adjust for the mask.
Okay.
What?
The screen.
Excuse me, we're adjusting the mask. We have to wear the mask to keep safe so far. Okay. I need a slow drum for suspense. Hold on, because the hands are heavy. Well, the bush ox couldn't do it, and the elephant couldn't do it. And the monkey couldn't do it. So guess who tried next? And he went, swoop, 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 swoop.
after the elephant, what animal tried next? The bush ox. Then the monkey. And who's next?
Lion.
And then the next animal tried?
Snake.
But then, one animal came up, and he had such a tender heart, and a voice, he said, King, oh king, when you die, I would like to marry your beautiful daughter. I'd like to try. And you know what the animals did? They started laughing. Can you start laughing? I want to try. And you know what the king said? Who knows what he can do until he first says try? He, the antelope, shall try. And the antelope went up. And the antelope was a beautiful dancer. Their drums, they could not bring their family members, they were taken from children and family, from the culture, from the land, but they held on to their songs and they held on to the stories. And this is a story about Aniko when she woke up and there was nobody in the land. So she had to find somebody to to be with because she had all this love in her heart. Where's your heart? All this love and no one to give it to her, so she started running because she was scared. And she kept running. And she kept running. And running, running, running. And then she got so tired she fell asleep. She fell asleep. Can you go to sleep? And then one by one, people came and they started looking at her. And she looked up and all these people were looking at her and they had long necks. Can you go and say long? Long necks. The babies had long necks. The children, the fathers had long necks. And she just had a shorter average size neck. And you know what they said? E. Can you say E?
E.
You look different. But she was so sweet and so sad, and she was crying, and she was all alone. They decided that she could come and live and go to their village and live with them. And they loved Amiko. They loved her dance, and they loved her song. It's shame. And he said, you are different from us. You've got a short neck. E, you're different. And there's no place for difference here. Aniko, you must go. And she heard all that meanness and cruelty and she started running. Can you start running? And she was running. And she was crying. And she was crying. And she was crying. The next morning they got up. They didn't hear Aniko's song. They didn't see her dance. They didn't hear her song. And they says,
have you seen Aniko?
Have you seen Aniko? Have you seen Aniko? Have you seen Aniko? No one saw her. They didn't know where she went. They said, well, the mean man, he was talking to her. Let's go talk to the mean man. And he says,
you came to congratulate me. I got rid of her. She's different, and there's no place for difference here. She had to go.
And they looked at him. They were so upset with him. But they said to themselves, he said, it's not the length of your neck or the color of your neck. It is what is in your heart and what you give to the world. And so they went to, and looked for Aniko. They went to find Aniko. And they sent out a few people to find Aniko. And when they found Aniko, you know what they did with her? They sang with her. And they danced with her. And then they gave her a big hug. Can you hug yourself? Yes. And they reminded her. And they reminded the mean man. It doesn't matter if you're different. Do like this. It doesn't matter if you're different. What matters is what is in your heart. Right here, and what you give to the world. Che che coole.
Che che coole.
Che che coole. Che coole. Come play the instruments. Che kofisa. Kofisa langa.
Kofisa langa.
Kofisa langa. La la chilanga.
La la chilanga.
La la chilanga.
La la chilanga.
Ooh alele. Ooh alele. Ooh alele. Che che coole,
che che coole,
che che
coole, che
che coole, che che
coole,
che che coole, che
che
coole, che che coole, la la chilanga,
la
la chilanga, alele, alele, che che coole.
Thank you.
one day in an African village, there was a lion, and he was a mean old lion. And he was going around eating families and all the babies, and he just gobbling up. He was greedy, and he ate more than he needed to eat. And they said, we need to do something about this lion. What are we gonna do? Rabbit said, I got you. I'll take care of that lion. So one day, he went to hopping. He goes to hopping, and hopping, and hopping, and he hopped right into the lion. And the lion went, roar. I'm gonna eat you up. He said, don't eat me up, old lion. I'm so sorry. Oh, you're such a wonderful lion. Please don't eat me up. I was trying to escape the wind because there's a hurricane coming. And it's gonna blow all the animals off the land. There's a hurricane coming. And it's gonna blow all the animals off the land. And he said, the lion said, really? Yes. There's a hurricane coming. And it's gonna blow all the animals out the land. There's a hurricane. And you remember last time when that hurricane came through, knocked over trees and everything. What? The lion said, well, what am I gonna do? Well, I'm running and I'm gonna hide in a hole. He said, but I'm too big to get in a hole. What am I gonna do? He said, Lion, why don't you lay low on the ground? So the lion laid low on the ground. Then he started thinking, what if the wind blow me away and I be blown off the earth? Because they thought the earth was flat. And he said, well, hug a tree, lion, hug a tree. So the lion goes to hug a tree. Can you hug a tree?
Tree right there.
Where's the tree? Oh, there is a tree right there in the library. And he hugged the tree. He said,
what if my arms get tired and I'm tired of hugging the tree? What am I going to do? I don't want the wind to blow me over.
And he said, oh, I got a good idea. And I just happen to have a rope with me. I tie you to a tree, lion. I'm going to tie you to a tree. And he started tying that lion to the tree. And tying that lion to the tree. And he says, is it tight enough? He said, I don't know, but I'll tighten it for you. And he pulled it. He said, well, I don't want the wind to blow me away. And he went, and he wrapped it more, and he, can you pull with me? And he pulled it. And then the lion stopped. He said, I don't hear no wind. Can you hear? Miss, can you hear wind? No. Lion said, I don't hear no wind either. That's what the rabbit said. And the lion was holding on that tree, and the rope all has his neck all tight. He said, he looked up, and ain't a leaf blowing on the tree. And he looked up. I don't see a rabbit looked up. I don't see a leaf blowing on a tree. I don't see a leaf blowing on a tree. He said, then untie me. And the rabbit went, up again. And he hopped away, and all of the animals came over. Can you guys give me your laugh again? And start laughing at the lion. We tricked you. Okay, so what time?
Sit down.
35.
Okay.
Sit down.
Those type of stories made slaves feel empowered. It was the stories and the songs. You ever feel really bad and you go read a book and you feel better? Or you listen to a song and you get to escape? So it helped them deal with what was going on. It kind of like brought wellness. It was therapy. Because remember I told you, for how many centuries were Africans enslaved? How many?
40?
3 centuries. So was their music. So they were shackled, but they were bringing their music. And they were shackled, but they were bringing their song. They were shackled, and they took their drums away, because drums were where they were communicating, but they knew. One day they were free at last, so the rhythm was in their heart. So the songs were in their heart. They were shackled, but they were bringing their music.
but they were bringing their song. Shackled, but they were bringing their rhythm. And one day, they'd know they'd be free at last. And so some of the songs, when they got to America, were songs about, can you say Underground Railroad?
Underground Railroad.
And the Underground Railroad was made of, do you think it was a railroad that went, that moved, went choo-choo, and was that the kind of railroad it was?
No.
No. What was the Underground Railroad? Did it help people? Yes.
It's where African Americans escaped from slavery.
And who helped them? All kind of people?
Yeah.
People of all faiths and all races? They helped African Americans get to safety. Did they hide them in their houses? So the Underground Railroad was a passage to the South, and they were hid in homes of people, people of all races and all races and all religions. And it was a secret that no one knew about. But the slaves would sing songs to let people know about it. And they would sing, Michael roll the boat ashore, hallelujah. Me, let me escape on the river, because when I go on the river, the dogs that were chasing me, that smelt my scent, can't find me when I get into the river, because when I get into the river, they can't get my scent. So there was a song that says, wade in the water, wade in the water, children. Churches, because they weren't supposed to dance, but they would go to the churches of what they called the master, and he would teach them about the things in the Bible. And so they start thinking, if this God delivers Moses, people, the children of Israel from Egypt, then this same God is going to deliver me. And they said, well, if Ezekiel fought the battle of Jericho, then one day there'll be a battle. And what was that battle in America that helped free slaves? The Civil War. And one day, I'm hoping. So I'm still dancing and dreaming, and I'm bringing my song, and I'm bringing my hope, and I'm bringing my visions, and I'm bringing new songs. And those new songs were, go down, Moses, way down in Egypt land. Telling Harriet, what was Harriet's, her last name starts with a T? Yes. Tubman. They were telling them that people like Harriet Tubman was going to come down, Michael row the boat ashore, or swing low, sweet chariot. Here's the story to say, this is how you free us. So these stories, these songs, and this dancing helped give them hope and a vision that they would be free at last one day. Okay? So, taboo, itata, iwata wata chenga,
iwata wata chenga,
babutu,
butu,
ita,
ita,
iwata wata chenga,
iwata wata chenga.
So I'm going to give you an opportunity now to come to the, we're going to have a drumming, we're going to teach you some things about the instruments. Come on down.
All right,
now it's your turn. They're going to do a drum song, and we're going to teach you some dancing.
Instruments in there.
You can grab any of the instruments. Come on. And we can have, if one of the parents wants to sit in the drum seat, we're going to dance.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're going to teach you about the instruments. You play some of the instruments? Come on.
Don't start, you have to grab a shaker.
And I have a parent.
Would you like to grab the thunder?
Would you like to
come and join? You want to shake that?
get our musicians together, and we're going to do our dance, okay? So whenever you're feeling low, and you're feeling down, you start your music, you start your song, or you dance. Okay? Okay, you want to have a seat right there? You ready?
Simple explanation, rather a demo, on some of the drum rhythms that I learned growing up while playing the djembe. Now, some of the drums that you guys also have aren't djembes. That is, I believe, a dunbe. That's a djembe. I also have kungas and bongos and stuff like that. But as a percussion artist and instrumentalist, I prefer djembes. They're just my cup of tea. But what I am going to do is something called call and response, all right? I'm going to play a rhythm, and I'd like for you guys, with whatever instrument you have, to mimic it as best as you can.
Ooh.
All right? Can we get down? Can we get down?
Yeah.
All right. First few rhythms are going to be kind of easy. Right? I'm not expecting you to get it the first time. Right? All right? Let's hit it. Shake the rhythm as best as I heard it. Okay. Now, does anyone out there have a rhythm that they'd like me to try and play? Anyone out there think they can challenge me? What's up, girl? Give me something. Look, I'm going to start out by playing a rhythm, and I'm going to actually break you guys into it. It's going to be three parts, all right? There's a high, a middle, and a low. And I'm going to try my best to work with the guys that have the drums so that we can pick up the bass and some of the shaker instruments, the middle part. I'm going to play all three for you real quick, and then I'm going to divide them all into groups. And we're going to try our best to play together, all right? The first rhythm is this. Second one is. Right. And the third one is. Alright. This is going to be so weird because you guys are a young group, fairly young. And if we don't get it, guys, at least we try. Alright. I'm not a conductor as well, you know, but percussion instruments, everybody does as best as they can. Hey, my drummers, can I have you guys do a standard and simple bass beat, just like this? Thank you.
Because you're going to be 12 years old, almost a man. And he asked his son what he wanted. And he said, son, what do you want? A statue? What? Can everybody say what?
What?
A statue! What? He said, what about a palace? What about diamonds? What about gold? He said, no, Dad, I want a statue. You say, what?
What?
He said he wanted a statue. And he said, Dad, I want that statue right outside of my window. And I want to look at that statue every day. And I want that statue to look like me. But this young man was born special, like all kids are special. But his back curled like this. And sometimes kids didn't play with him because he looked different. And he said, his son, he started thinking, but they're already teasing my son, and he wants a statue of himself with his back like that. They're just gonna tease him. It's just gonna be mean. It's just not gonna be a nice thing. What do I do? He said, what about if I buy you ponies or buy you a boat? He said, no, Daddy, I want a statue of myself, and I want it outside my window, and I want to look at that statue every day. Every day I want to look at that statue. Oh, but Dad, I don't want the statue as I appear, but I want the statue as I'm going to be one day. And I want that statue tall and strong and standing straight and tall. And sometimes things change. People go to therapy. Some things don't change. But in this case, there was a change going on because this is what happened every day. Every day, his father put that statue outside, and every day he would stretch. Can you guys stretch? Ooh. Stretch, then stretch up like this, stretch. And every day, every week, sometimes he would stretch several times a day. Can you stretch up like that again? Ooh, can you reach me? I can reach you. Look at that statue. Now reach up to your dreams and everything you want to be one day, despite what people say. Ooh, can you feel it in your shoulders? Say, yeah?
Yeah.
He did this every day. 365 days a year, every month. How many months are there in a year?
12.
He did it every week. How many days in a week?
Seven.
And he did it every day. How many hours in a day?
24.
But sometimes he slept, so he didn't do it every hour. But he did this. When he turned 18, all of a sudden, his shoulders, from all the stretching and all the therapy, moved back. and he stood straight up tall. And he says, Dad, see, as thou seest, can you repeat after me? As thou seest,
as thou seest,
thou beest.
Thou beest.
So you need to see yourself as doctors and lawyers and teachers right now. You need to see yourself as writers right now and write your book and tell your story. Because you're awesome. Can you say, I am awesome?
I am awesome.
Love you. Give a big hug to yourself. I love me some me. I'm so awesome. And the father hugged his son and he says, I'm so proud of you, but I like you just the way you are. Whether you change it or not, I like you just the way you are. Okay, we have one more story and then we're going to end with a song. Okay, and I'm hoping that story encourages you. This is another story. And this is for parents too. This is for all of us. One day, there was a king. He was a sultan. This is a solar story from Central America. Central Africa, Africa. And this sultan had this wife who was so frail, and she was getting sick all the time, and she really wasn't happy. And she, can you, I can't see your sad face because we're in a mask, but you can give me your sad eyes. You can give me a sad posture. And when he'd be in town, they go to town, she'd look like this, and he's the king, and he's walking all proud and that, but she was really sad. Then one day, he sees this poor man who doesn't have as much money as the sultan, and his wife is happy, and she's singing, and she's giggling, and she's laughing, and they're whispering in each other's ears. And she's so happy. But the sultan, his king, his wife was sad. She walked like this. She was so sad. This is what happened. The rich king says, I want that wife. I'm the king. I can have anybody I want to. Listen, you take my sad wife, and she's so frail. I want that healthy, happy wife. And he took the healthy, happy wife, and he took her to the palace. And every time something happens, like she dropped a fork or something, he would say, you're so stupid. What are you doing? And she was so uncomfortable with him that every time, and he never talked to her, and she sat by herself, and this happy, giggly woman began to get like this. He says, what's the matter with you? You live in a palace. You're rich. Why are you so sad? You're stupid. And he said mean things. Is that mean? Is that nice to say back? Thumbs down. Why don't you act like everybody else? You should be happy. You're married to me. He was so mean to her. And so she got smaller and smaller and smaller. And then he goes to the market with his servants. Leaves the wife, and he sees this man with his wife that he had taken, and she's giggling, and she's happy, and he's healthy, and he said to her, I love you. You're so special. You have beautiful eyes. I believe in you. I love your singing. I love to listen to your stories. And she was like, she was so happy. And the rich king says, why are you happy with this poor man? You weren't that happy with me. And he says, I've got more money than this poor man. Why are you so happy? And she says, when he comes home, he listens to me. He shares his story. He listens to my story. If I make a mistake, he never puts me down. He is kind to me. And the sultan looked very sad. And he realized what he was missing. Because the poor man says, I feed her the meat of the tongue. There's power in life in the tongue. And the part I miss telling you is that he had tried to feed her all kinds of different tongues, but he didn't understand that it was his what? What he was, his words. So I want you to say to yourself, even if somebody says mean things to you, I am great. Can you hear this? I am great.
I am great.
I can do.
I can do.
I am awesome.
I am awesome.
And then when people are having bad days and they say mean things to you, based on how you look, where you live, what your color is, like we learned in our stories, we forgive them. We don't fight. And we talk to somebody who's hurting us. Back in the day, as I said, Africans couldn't change where they lived and what happened to them, and they grew up and they died in slavery, but what they could change is how they responded. What they could not take from us is our singing and our dancing and our song. So they were shackled, but they were bringing the song. They were shackled, but they were bringing. Thank you so much for letting me share with you this story, African American. That's awesome. And you can still play with the instruments if you want to, as we. Okay, thank you so much.